We present Do We Need a Faster Mouse? An empirical evaluation of asynchronicity-induced jitter. I'm Auejin Ham, and I'm presenting this paper on behalf of my collaborators Junsu Lim and Sunjun Kim. Intricate systems like the peripherals we're using to watch this video can be divided into input and output device. Input and output device send and receive information under a specific frequency. For input device, we call it polling rate, while for the monitor device, we call it display frequency. When an interactive system has no latency and noise, can we expect its display to render the movement of the mouse as accurately as possible? Let us imagine a mouse moving at a uniform speed. From now on, a horizontal axis represents displacement, and a vertical axis represents time. We will assume that the mouse polling rate and the display frequency are constant. Since our mouse will update the cursor for a given polling frequency, we expect several cursor data to be discarded. Highlighted cursors represent the ones that are actually polled by the operating system. We can see that each polled cursor maintains a constant gap over both time and displacement axis. Therefore, we now understand that our PC will correctly poll a constant mouse gap from a uniform speed mouse if the polling rate is constant. We will oversample this for the sake of easier visualization. Same as before, our display will render polled cursor under its own frequency. Interestingly, a different index of cursors is selected from each batch if the polling rate and display frequency differ. Over here, highlighted cursors represent what our display renders over time. We can see that each rendered cursor has the same vertical gap, but we also observe a skipping frame over the horizontal displacement axis. This shows that some cursors pulled from a mouse might not be rendered, resulting in uneven gap of cursors. We can now understand how jitter can occur over a cursor without systemic latency and noise. This kind of jitter is called asynchronicity-induced jitter. So, is there any way to enhance accuracy of our peripherals? It is already known that a high polling rate of a USB signal line can improve temporal performance, and studies have tested a polling rate of up to 1000 Hz. Recently, a USB mouse with an 8000 Hz polling rate was introduced and has been examined in gaming communities. Even though the improvement on the faster devices is prominent in numbers, it is not known how high mouse and display speeds should be for jitter to be imperceptible. Moreover, in-depth analysis of the perceptual threshold of jitter has been limited. So in this paper, we are tackling this issue. Before going into details, we will quickly overview the key findings of our research. Long story short, can the asynchronicity-induced jitter be perceived? Yes, a temporal jitter of 0.306 milliseconds or higher can be perceived. Then, how fast should our mouse be to minimize jitter? In general, high mouse polling rates of over 2000 Hz exhibit good performance under a wide range of display frequencies. Lastly, do jitters matter more for high-ranked gamers? No, high-ranked gamers had no significant difference on either perception and pointing task performance compared to the non-rankers. To measure difference in the aspects of jitter, we had to generate wide range of jitter from off-the-shelf desktop environments. We applied a theoretical model of asynchronicity-induced jitter into our system and validated accuracy of our spinning polar system. A recent study from UIST 2020 proposed a theoretical model to calculate the size of temporal and spatial jitters induced by asynchronous input and output signal rates. Their model calculates the expected mean of temporal jitters from constant mouse polling rate and display frequency. To apply this model in our context, we first had to achieve and maintain the condition where peripheral frequencies dominate the size of jitter and additional components of a real-world system such as messaging pipeline, signal latencies, etc. Therefore, we developed a logger software utilizing a spinning for loop method to collect mouse events using a thread spinning in a controlled display frequency. We validated its polling rate and temporal jitter accuracy by comparing our measurements with those from the low-level API and the theoretical model. Our validations concluded that our apparatus was sufficiently fast and rendered the overall cursor jitter characteristics correctly. After validating our experiment setup, we were able to go back and tackle this issue. In this paper, we measured perceptual threshold and the performative effect of jitter. In the first part, we examined perceptual user experience under different jitter levels using the triangle test protocol. In the second part, we measured the polling test performance for different jitter levels using the phase law test. For the apparatus, we used a state-of-the-art display and experimental high polling rate mouse devices to provide an extreme range of jitter levels aiming at high-end gaming environments. To compensate for the limited choice of stimuli granularity, we performed the triangle test, which is considered one of the most frequently used discrimination tests for determining whether participants can distinguish two different stimuli. Our experiment was designed in a mixed manner, with the display frequencies as between subject factors and the polling rates as within subject factors. This was because different display frequencies introduced more noticeable differences in the cursor movement than the effect of jitter. Under a given display frequency, the participants were asked to distinguish the reference 8000Hz polling rate from four lower polling rates using the triangle test procedure. The participants examined a white cursor moving on a black full screen display, focusing irregularity on the cursor trajectories. We recruited 23 participants from a local university, and 9 of them were ranked as the top 20% players of one or more FPS or MOBA games. Hereafter, we will call them rankers. These are the scores of our triangle test by jitter conditions. The expected amount of jitter is written inside brackets. The figure shows that a temporal jitter size less or equal to 0.3 milliseconds expected to be imperceptible in our experiment setting. Wilcoxon's signed rank test showed no significant difference in the triangle test scores of the rankers and non-rankers, implying that high-skill game players are not necessarily more sensitive to the size of jitter. From participants, we asked their most used peripherals and calculated their expected size of jitter using a theoretical model. Over half of the participants could distinguish jitters smaller than those in the average non-ranker environment, whereas no participant could distinguish the jitter in the average ranker environment. This implies that peripherals of the current rankers might be sufficient for minimizing perceptible jitters. After the triangle test, we conducted a standard Fitch law test to examine the effect of the zero level on the pointing performance quantitatively. The experiment used a 2x5 within subject design with two factors, display frequency and mouse polling rate. Under each jitter condition, 18 combinations of 3 amplitudes and 6 target widths were set. New ranker participants were recruited who are or were ranked in the top 20% players of games demanding extensive mouse control skills. Figure below illustrates the mean throughputs of each participant under each condition. A two-factor repeat measures ANOVA showed that polling rate, display frequency, and their interaction did not have any significant main effect on the pointing performance in the throughput. We also conducted linear regression analysis of the jitter size and the throughput. The blue solid line illustrates the Spearman correlation between the throughput and the median raw temporal jitter, whereas the red dashed line shows their Spearman correlation without the worst jitter condition. The results indicate a very weak negative correlation between the jitter and the throughput, but this amount were not statistically significant. To conclude, we found out that we mined in a mouse with a slightly higher polling rate than the current de facto standard mouse polling rate limitation at 1000Hz. Subsequently, we suggest people have different sensitivity towards the size of jitter. However, mouse control skills are not necessarily correlated to it. And finally, our results show that off-the-shelf peripherals of high-ranking game players may be sufficient to suppress the jitter in the perceivable range. Even though we found no significant effect of jitter in the performance of target pointing task, a wide range of jitter sensitivity implies some tasks might take advantage of reducing the perceivable amount of jitter. From our experimental results, we tabulated a set of good and bad display and mouse combinations. Mouse polling rates less than or equal to 500Hz introduce noticeable jitters at all display frequencies, whereas polling rates more than 2000Hz are clearly good. Interestingly, while using a mouse with a polling rate of 1000Hz, the de facto standard limit of a USB mouse, a higher frame rate display may introduce more jitter than the lower one. Thank you for listening, and please leave a comment if you have any questions.